Welcome to an academy. I'm Krishna Verma, a verified educator, and in today's lesson I'm going to discuss about types of supercharger. How many types of superchargers are used in different types of engines like automobile engine, marine engine, aircraft engine, etc. And what is the working of these type of supercharger for different type of engine? I'm going to discuss in today's lesson. So let's start our lesson. These are the contents of today's lesson. I'm going to discuss about different type of supercharger and the description of these types of superchargers. So let's start our lesson. Basically, there are different types of superchargers are used in different supercharged engine, and these types of superchargers are there are basically five types of superchargers we generally consider, and these superchargers are reciprocating compressor type supercharger, vane blower type supercharger, Lysolm compressor type supercharger, root blower type supercharger, and centrifugal compressor type supercharger. So I'm going to discuss these supercharger one by one. So I'll start with the first type of supercharger, that is reciprocating compressor type supercharger. Basically, this type of supercharger is not very popular in these days, and these type of supercharger are basically or generally used in stationary engine or stationary installation. For stationary installation, these type of superchargers are generally used, and these type of superchargers are basically reciprocating compression piston or reciprocating piston compressor type supercharger. And as I told you, these type of superchargers are not very popular because it has some problems or it has some disadvantages, like these systems are quite bulky and heavy, and these systems are speed limited system. And here the size of the compressor, whatever compressor are using, so the size of the compressor is based on the volume of the air which is supplied, and this type of compressor has higher compression ratio. So these are the points by which these are not using these in the current scenario these days. That's why it is not popular in current scenario. Second type of supercharger is vane blower type supercharger. See, this vane blower type supercharger is basically a positive displacement rotary type supercharger, and this is the diagram which is representing the vane blower type supercharger. Here this diagram or this vane blower type supercharger generally consists a rotor which has four slots, the rotor which has four slots, and this rotor rotate in the large cylindrical casing. This is the casing, so the rotor rotate in the large cylindrical casing, and this rotor rotate in the casing at that particular time, this rotor is in contact with the casing at one point, and it is in contact with the casing at one point for each rotation. For each rotation we consider this rotor is in contact with the casing at only one point. So this is representing the construction of the vane blower type supercharger. And here we also consider the blades. So the blades of the rotor, here we consider there are a number of blades in the rotor, so these blades of the rotor slide radially in or out in the slots of the rotor. These blades slides radially in or out in the slots, and the radius of the rotor we generally consider as the eccentric or the position of the radius, or the radius is mounted eccentrically in this particular type of supercharger. And if we consider when the blade move outside, so at that particular time the air enters into the system, and this air moves between the blades, and that particular time the space increases between the blades, and if we considering the space between the blades are decreasing, so at that particular time we consider discharge of the air. We generally consider discharge of the air, and this system is generally considered as the speed limited system. So because of the radial motion of the vanes, because the vanes moves radially, so these system are generally considered as the obsolete system. These system are not using in the current scenario. Third type of supercharger is the Lysolm compressor type supercharger. This is basically a positive displacement rotary supercharger, and this is the diagram of this particular type of supercharger. It has helical rotor and the casing. You can see in this diagram. So this has helical rotor and the casing. So when the air enter at one end, we are considering this end. So when the air enter at the one end of the compressor, and it get trapped between the rotor and the casing of this particular type of supercharger, and it produce constant compression also. And the compression generally we consider at the opening of the exhaust port. We generally consider compression during the opening of the exhaust valve or exhaust port. And here air displaces actually because of the helical shape rotor. Because of this helical shape rotor, the air this particular air displaces actually. But these type of superchargers are quite complicated type system, so these are not used much in current scenario. So this is about the Lysolm compressor type supercharger. Next type of supercharger is root blower type supercharger. This root blower type supercharger generally consists a casing. This is the diagram. This diagram is representing the root blower type supercharger, and this system consists a casing. This is the casing, and there are two cylindrical shaped lobed. You can see these are the lobe, and these are cylindrical shaped lobes. So these cylindrical shaped lobes situated in the casing and rotate in opposite direction. They are rotating in opposite direction, and air is generally induced between the space of the rotor. Here you can see at the inlet, from the inlet the air enter, and it move with the rotor up to the discharge point or the outlet. You can see in this particular diagram. And here we also consider no compression of the air at the particular inlet point, but we consider compression only during when the discharge port is open. At the discharge port open condition, we consider the compression, and during compression we consider the pressure of the air is increases. And we also consider backflow during the opening of the exhaust port. So the backflow of the air is also considered during the opening of the exhaust port. So if we want proper compression, so to compress the air, we generally require some extra work done for the compression process. So because of this work done of the system, it reduces the thermal efficiency of the system. Because of the backflow, it reduces the thermal efficiency of the system. These root blower type supercharger have some problem of leakage and noise. The cylindrical lobe we are using in this particular type of supercharger, cylindrical lobe. So this, for because of this, we face some problem of leakage and noise. So to overcome this problem, these supercharger comes with some minor modification. So nowadays, these type of supercharger in this particular type of supercharger, the helical shaped lobes are generally used. The lobes of helical shape, the in the particular rotor, or we can say the lobes which are used, the shape of the lobes are helical shape, and a number of lobes are increased. Like in previous one, there are two lobes are using. So this time nowadays there are three lobes are used for the proper movement and the compression of the air. Here number of lobes are increases by 3. So these 3 lobes are used for the proper movement of the air and the compression of the air. So because of this modification, it create less noise, it create less vibration, as well as it run at higher efficiency. higher efficiency, and we generally consider this type of supercharger or this type of compressor run at higher speed, around 1.5 time of the engine speed, and the air which is supplied, it reduce or during the working or during the supply, we generally consider reduced supply of the air. And these root blower type of supercharger is generally cost friendly. The cost of these type of supercharger we generally consider cheaper. So these type of superchargers are cost friendly, and mechanical efficiency is also we consider good. And these type of superchargers does not require any kind of lubrication, but it has volumetric efficiency low. It has less volumetric efficiency during the operation because of the combined effect of compression of the air and the backflow. These are the main reason for the less volumetric efficiency. And these root blower type of supercharger are generally used for the low and medium speed engine, or we can say for the stationary and marine engine. So this is about the root blower type supercharger. And this diagram is representing the extra work which is done on the system in the previous one, in the two cylindrical shape or lobes condition. Because of this extra work, generally for two lobes condition, the thermal efficiency is decreases. So because of that, we need some modification in that particular type of system. That's why we need three helical lobe system that used to improve the efficiency of the system. So this was about the root blower type supercharger. Now next type of supercharger is the centrifugal compressor type supercharger. This is the diagram which is representing the centrifugal type supercharger. Centrifugal compressor type supercharger. This system is generally consists of close fitting casing. You can see here, this is representing the close fitting casing or the volute casing, in which the rotor or the impeller rotate. This is representing the rotor or the impeller. It rotate in this particular type of casing, and this casing has radial vanes. These are the vanes, and these vanes are we consider the radial vanes, and air generally enter in this particular type of compressor axially. The air enter actually at the hub. This is the hub, so air enter actually at the hub of this particular type of system, and it has radial vanes. So air turns 90 degree with these radial vanes. The air turns 90 degree with the radial vanes. So because of we are considering centrifugal action, so we get here high velocity air, and then this air pass through the diffuser. This air pass to the diffuser where the pressure of the air increases, and again further this air will transfer to the engine. And in this particular type of system, we generally consider gear setup drive which drive the compressor. So the gear system is used to drive the compressor in this particular type of system. And we can say efficiency wise, cost wise, construction wise, this type of system are very good. The performance of the system is very good. Efficiency wise, the efficiency of the system is higher compared to other system. And this type of compressor has a pressure ratio around 1.5 to 3. And this is generally common for the supercharging. And these type of superchargers are generally used for the aircraft engines or these constant speed engine. But there is some disadvantage of this particular type of supercharger. This type of system has generally problem of surging. Surging problem takes place during the process. So because of this, it reduces the flow of air as well as the pressure ratio of the air. So this, because of this, it causes instability of the engine. So this was about the centrifugal type of compressor, and this was all about the different type of compressor or different type of all five different type of superchargers. So according to design of the engine and the application, different engines are used, different engine use different type of supercharger. So these type of supercharger are used on the basis of design as well as the application of the engine. Thank you so much for watching, and please subscribe the channel for the more lectures, and please subscribe the Unacademy, and you can follow me. This is my Unacademy link, so you can follow me on this link also. Thank you so much.